Yeah? Okay, yeah, it works. Yeah, it's 11 o'clock sharp, so I suggest that we will start with this session. And the first presenter of the session is Sven Erik Soosaar from the Institute of the Estonian Language, and he will present a paper on ensuring vocabulary consistency for under-resourced languages. So, yes, Sven Erik.
Thank you very much. I will present we wrote a presentation together with Valts, Ernštreits, who is head of Livonian Institute at the University of Latvia, but unfortunately he could not come today. So I will present our presentation titled "Ensuring Vocabulary Consistency for an Under-Resourced Language with Limited Data." I will tell you about the problems with consistency, why is it important in dictionaries. Then I will make a short introduction to Livonian and its lexicographical resources. And then I will talk about our project, which is still going on. So we have only some preliminary results, but we will also tell about our plans. Consistency of lexicographical sources. Why is it important? It's an important effect, aspect of lexicography, as it contributes to the even representation of the language, and its lexical core and ontologies. It is also essentially if lexicographical source is used for the language acquisition, especially in the case of endangered or underdocumented and also under-resourced languages, because in case of such languages, often there is not enough materials. There are limited number of persons who know language, so often language is fragmentally documented, and language corpus is very small, so you cannot use the same methods and that you can use in big languages like English or even Estonian. So, and it's also crucial if everyday use of language is limited in domains where language users lack sufficient proficiency in some particular domain or in general. This is in case of several, or actually most of endangered languages, where there are few persons who are fluent in language, this language, and they often live in different locations, so they can't really interact and use language. And language learners need consistent lexicographical resources to learn the language. So if they don't have such resources, they can't use it normally. They have gaps in their vocabulary, so they can't talk in normal way, and they had to use just raw loans from the main language or switch to the dominant language. There are, like I said, methods that can be used for common languages. They can not often use for languages that have limited resources. But dictionaries of the basic vocabulary provide data on core lemmas needed for the language acquisition. And also frequency dictionaries, corpus statistics, provide data of the frequency of lemmas. But for underdocumented and endangered languages, such tools are not available. But nevertheless, such languages also deserve to be represented consistently. So let's go on to Livonian, which is a language we are researching. Livonian is an officially recognized indigenous language in Latvia, and one of the most endangered languages in the world. Actually, there have been in the last decade several news that the last speaker of Livonian died, but still Livonian is alive, although there was some period where Livonian was not transmitted in normal way from parents to children, but there were still children who learned Livonian from their grandparents. So there was one generation lost, but now these children who learned from grandparents, they have grown up, and although Livonian is maybe not their first language is Latvian, but they are bilingual, and they a number of such younger people can conversate in Livonian. So nowadays there are estimates that about 20 persons can conversate quite fluently in Livonian, although still 100 years ago there was 1,000 or even more Livonian speakers, but Second World War dispersed these Livonians all over the world in Russia, in places in Latvia, also in Sweden, in and even in America and Canada. So the one of the last speakers who learned as a first language Livonian actually died in Canada in I think about 10 years ago, being over 100 years old. But nowadays there is a rising interest for the acquisitions of the Livonian within the Livonian community, and there are every summer camps where children gather and are studying Livonian and also practicing it with their teachers and with each other. And interest for the language use is growing inside the community, and there are also resources created for this. Livonian is an Uralic language, as also Estonian and Finnish, and also Hungarian. And Estonian is its closest relative of Livonian. But during the centuries, Baltic tribes assimilated many Livonians, and Livonian has been deeply impacted by Latvian and as a main content language, and but also Latvian has had a lot of influence from Livonian, as speakers of Livonian have switched to Latvian, and they brought their language traits into Latvian. And access to the Livonian is also important for the proper understanding of the linguistic developments in the Latvia and also the region, because it is the key for the Livonian intangible cultural heritage. Here is a map of Livonian 12th century based on historical dialectological research. Only this brown area, tip of this peninsula, remained Livonian speaking. And this small dot here, brown, this was another dialect that was spoken until the middle of 19th century. So there are two dialects that are documented quite well, and this modern Livonian is based on this Western Livonian area language. So about Livonian lexicography, Livonian is and has been used in limited language domains and documented scarcely and unevenly. And most or actually all the lexicographical sources of Livonian are based on fieldwork data, and that's they are currently the Livonian dictionary that contains about 12,000 Livonian lemmas, and this is also first it was published in 2012 as a book, and but now it's also available as a database on a digital platform is available in web. Address is livonian.tech, and this is being instantly updated from the Livonian language corpus during the annotation and other sources. So a brief overview of lexicographical sources of Livonian. The first dictionary was published in 1861 by Anders Sjögren, and it contained 6,000 Livonian head words. And then was 1938 Lauri Kettunen's dictionary with about 8,500 Livonian head words. And Livonian head words, but the dictionaries are collected from fieldwork data, and that means that they lack consistency in terms or even basic everyday vocabulary. For example, even not all the names of the months were existent in this recent dictionary, and even the word for please, for some reason, was missing. So it reflects the data that was gathered. So there are no existing data collections or resources for Livonian that can offer an adequate perception of the core vocabulary or vocabulary frequency for the Livonian. And the corpus is heavily disbalanced. One third of corpus represents religious literature, which is a translation of the New Testament, and another third fairy tales and legends. So you can imagine that in this corpus, very high on frequency lists are words like God, God, or sin, or bless, because of this translation of New Testament. And the simplest and probably most effective way of for approaching cost instance issues is frequency data. And one example is used for three separate sources. Skip that, but it was done before to ensure the consistency and that the core of the vocabulary was would grow evenly, not sequentially. So for the Livonian, how we achieve consistency? As I said, frequency data is distorted to uneven documentation of sources. And the database is trilingual, thus frequency and consistency data of Latvian and Estonian may be also used. As Estonian is very relatively close to Livonian, and Latvian is the main influenced languages, so we can use data from both of these languages to gain perspective for Livonian. And we have combined three sets of data, frequency data from Latvian, using Latvian frequency data from balanced corpus and Latvian texts, and frequency data from the Livonian corpora, both processed and annotated and unprocessed corpus despite distortions. Combining data from these languages may provide a data set that is close to the Livonian actual data. The general goal is to identify missing vocabulary so that we can specifically look for that vocabulary from sources. So currently we have applied a list of 5,000 Estonian basic vocabulary to the Estonian translations in this biggest Livonian dictionary, and identified that only 3,100 lemmas or concepts are included with 1,900 missing. Of course, it was 12,000 this dictionary, so you can see that even such a big dictionary doesn't contain all the necessary words. And the types of missing vocabulary, some basic vocabulary, like I said, some names of months, words missing for some specific reason, like compound verbs or adverbs expressed by other meanings in other means in Latvian or Livonian. So some examples there, and specific Estonian words or concepts not known or not having precise equivalent in Latvia. And sometimes even outdated terms are present. So what are the next steps? We will build a properly consistent dictionary more with more data from combined sources. And based on acquired data, targeted search for lemmas, concepts will be executed to fill the gaps. As the Livonian vocabulary has been lacking in number of domains, language planning and creation of new lemmas should take place. And we are planning to create a Livonian language commission in this year. And data sets acquired during this research may be used for consistency ensuring purposes for other under-sourced languages, as English translations are also added to this database at livonian.tech. But of course, especially those of Finnic or Uralic origin, but in principle, all endangered languages can have some use of it. So that's all. Thank you.
Thank you for a fascinating insight in the Livonian case. Are there any questions?
Thank you, Sven Erik. Who do you think could evaluate if your dictionary would be properly set up and including all necessary words? Who could evaluate this? If there are no many Livonian speakers?
There are not many Livonian speakers, but there still are. So I think these Livonian speakers can in the first place to evaluate this, but also I think that other members of Livonian community who don't have a command of Livonian language but would like to use it, so they can say that, oh, there is a missing word that is very important for us, so why is it not here? So they can make proposals which words should still be included in our dictionary database.
More questions?
Yes. Yes. I'm actually from Latvia, so this topic is kind of important for me, even if I don't know Livonian language, but for Latvian language it's really important, and because many contemporary Latvian words are coming from Livonian. Mm-hmm. This is one thing that we also learned in school, and why we value Livonian so much. But I just find very interesting parallels between Livonian and Hebrew process of reconstruction, because both languages was distinct and now they are reconstructed, and I guess we should look at this process as reconstruction and not be too critic about kind of how close to some imaginative original this result is, because nobody knows anymore. We should look at result more what is the purpose of these dictionaries that we're getting, because we need them today for specific purposes, for say people who want to learn this language, to talk with this language. They need both words, both grammar. And but my question was two questions. What is this Livonian
Livonian too, but mostly Latvians, yeah. Or Livonians, of course.
Yeah, and also yeah. sourcing words from relative languages, related languages, meaning you talked much about Estonian as source for Livonian. Did you do something with Finnish? Are there also a relation with Finnish, and can Finnish be source at least partially for some words?
Yeah, we have not compared in our project Finnish, because Finnish is also a Finnic language, but it does not have direct contact with Livonian, because Livonian Estonians and Livonians had direct contact for many centuries. They were like neighbors. So they have also influenced some dialects in Estonia and Livonian. There were marriages, people going to Livonia and coming from there and married to Estonia. So there is much more direct contact with Estonian. So. Material if we use Latvian and Estonian.
Thank you. I think we have to stop here because otherwise we'll run into problems. But thank you.